today's new stream. This time we will try to finish the dragon that we started last time upon your request. This one. And still Mrs. Wings, of course. And we're going to get it ready to be used inside Spine for animation. So last time, let's go over a bit what we decided. Hello, hello, Fabiana. Nice to see you. So last time, what we did was sketching it first, deciding the design of the dragon. And we have a color palette here, sketch with the wings. And we also had some pictures somewhere. Yes. Which were the dragon fruit that we took as inspiration for the skin of the dragon. We're going to make a dragon fruit. Yes. And so we need to finish the various details. I'll try not to go too much into detail because it's like a flow of mine to try to add so many details. But that would mean that we won't finish this asset into today's stream, so I'll try to not do too much. Hi, Noriena! And what we did is we placed some tags here in Photoshop. So we have an ignore tag here on sketches so that when we will run the Photoshop script from file, script, Photoshop to Spine. Oh, and of course it came out on the wrong window. It will be able to ignore this folder and instead just export what we want. So I'm not going to use the fancy settings that I used for the dudes last time or two times ago, because I already displayed. If you don't remember, there's always the help section of the script, and there's also a previous video when I explain it. So today I'm just going to use the merge tag, which is the most useful for me to just have the what I need. So, and maybe the slot tag for the wings, as we're going to paint them in the upside and when they are down. And what else? Let's mainly go over about how we decided to split the dragon in parts. Make just a tiny sketch here. So we'll have not many parts really. Let's use some other brush, maybe this one. Ah, whatever, it's fine. But I need a color that will be seen. So pick this intense blue, it will do. So, of course, we're going to need the upper part of the head, the lower part, and then of course we need the tongue, because it's going to do rah and growl, so it will be hidden inside its mouth. Then the eye and eye socket, and then we have these pieces separate to be able to move it. Then here, this body is just one piece. We can also export this as one single piece, and the legs as well. We'll have two pieces of this. I'll probably make a copy of the front one and change the shadows for the one behind. Hello, Fitzflow. And here we have the tail. It will be a single piece, and I won't leave it straight. I'm just painting it straight because it's the best setting for rigging. It's easier if we want to make it curl to paint it straight instead. And then we're going to have the wings in two pieces, because I want the upper part to be able to go over this lower part here. Okay, and then of course I already mentioned that we need the wings and stuff. So I resume doing this. I also changed the style since last time, and I'm trying to do a style more popular in other kinds of game. To display how one thing is done. So, my technique is to have some flat layer like this base here. Yeah, let's go over this. So, I hope it can help people who maybe are a bit more new on this. So, for each piece, my organization is I have a folder with the merge tag. Ooh, and I noticed this is emerge tag instead of merge. There was a typo. Saving. And in this folder, if I do have lines, I'll keep them on a separate layer. Yes, Fabiana, I included doings in the piece list. I displayed them earlier. And it's just that the sketch does not display them and I didn't draw the white thing yet. So it's likely that you didn't notice. Okay, back to this. Oh, no problem. So I have a base, a white base. And this base, I usually paint it in a single color to have something to start with and have a clear outline. And then I created an action last time that will make a multiply layer for me. And this layer I always use the same color for shadows, which I decided it's this nice violet here, which is this one, purple rather than violet. It's a multiply mode, I don't want this. Okay, so it's always the same instead. Also the opacity should be at 100%. And what I'm mainly using for this specific style is a soft brush, and the lights in my case come from up, like almost evenly up or front, yes, so that even if you flip the skeleton it won't look strange. And for the lights, so the shadows are in multiply mode, opacity 50%, and this is the color. And then when I'm set for something, let's see, where are my, okay. So this is the color that I decided I'd use for the skin of the dragon. This one, which is the same as here and it's here. Those were just palettes. And, or maybe it's not the same. Maybe I placed something else. I'll check. It's because I added some shadow. It means nothing. So let me check. Opacity 100%. And I usually draw it as a base color. Now it looks less brilliant than the ones I was using here. So just to make sure, I'll open something that I already did, which is the head skull, and I'll deactivate. So this is the color that I used as base. And okay, so now I'll deactivate this again, and I'll give this. Okay, what? It's because I did it on the wrong layer. Okay, now everything is fine. So this is my base color. Then I start giving some shadows with this color here. Of course, I had the wrong tool selected. So something of the sort. Then with Cool Dragon, I use a Cintiq 13 HD. By Wacom, which is the smallest kind of Cintiq. It fits inside a backpack. It fits inside a backpack and is the same size of my screen, so it's awesome for me. And oh, no problem. Then after I do this, my technique is to have a like this big, it's always a brush, which is the basic one, but with lower opacity, and I use it to get this effect here. Now I'm doing it very quickly and I redo it. It's just to get you the idea. And then at the end, then I add some shadows again, because I took out too many shadows. Well, I have to do it again there. And this is to give some basic three-dimensionality. Then I may add another layer to have it more dark, like in this case. And then I'll add another layer with clipping mask and linear dodge or color dodge, I don't remember, at maybe again 50%, and I'll use the opposite color as this one, so here, this, to make the lights. Maybe it wasn't linear dodge, maybe it was color dodge, yes, way better, see? And this gives a very nice effect, so then I'll maybe make it less strong here. And of course I want this part to blend very well with the other parts. So also I have to figure out, because of course this part is required to be able to turn. So we need to have something here to allow us to make it bend nicely. So not too many scales, maybe I reduce them or make it more uniform, or I'll figure out something. And then I'll add some details and so on. So I got to a basic idea. I can do the same for this, because leaving it all white and sad, it's not what we want. There, we have another one. We can do the same for the tail. Where's my tail? Here, block the layer, fill it. And, oh, here we can already do, this is an easy one. So, we'll take here, brush. See, and I just do this. Maybe I also remove the leg front. And why not the body? Okay. So I'll give it first, maybe I use even a bigger brush so that it's softer. Then, since I got on parts that I didn't want to influence, I'll erase some, especially here on the top. Whoops! Oh, there's the light of the lamp that is preventing me from seeing super well what I'm doing. Okay, have to fix it. Okay, so since this is so strong, I'll have to lower, I have to add the ugly spacing that I don't really like here to get it smoother. This is also nice because it kind of justifies the fact that the light comes, like if this bends, it would be strange if this would be completely dark, because the lights would not make sense. Oh, and I'm doing this. I should remove this option here. Why is it doing this? No shape dynamics. Okay, way better. Okay, this is the last time I do this. Then I erase. Right. And then I do the top. Okay, so it looks like a tube, some sort of tube, yes. So don't want the opacity to be super strong, so. Is the smoothing something you add with an extension? Nope. I'm doing it by hand, and it sucks to do it like this in Photoshop. Unless you're mentioning the this sort of smoothing. So now, do I have smoothing? Yes, a little bit. I'm using an extension, which is this one. Didn't want to, like, it does what it does is this. Oh, I wanted this color. And if I use a massive smoothing, then it does this and the lines just come out perfect and I don't have to redo them like 1,000 times, so I use this extension to cheat. And usually I just leave it too subtle, because when it's off, it's not as bad as usual, but I prefer to have my lines smoothed out a little bit. Because I'm not saying I have Parkinson, but my hand tends to tremble a lot. And this just removes the weird trembling that I leave behind. Then I have to reactivate some of this stuff. Where's my tail? Here. So I might do as well another action, which I keep repeating that I'll do, I haven't done it yet, to add the color dodge. And I select this, I have to change the settings again. Let's check if the brush is right, yes. I think there is a new smooth option in the last Photoshop CC. Oh yes, it's probably this one, isn't it? If I had known. But the cool thing about that extension is that it allows to build this isometric graphics very easily. So I'll just display this quickly because I like it a lot. Where is it? Isometric. See, and you can start, and it's everywhere, it works in any program, not just Photoshop, so super useful. And then you do these and these, and wow, considering I'm so bad at drawing straight lines and all the same, and for me it's perfect. And then I remove the other stuff. There is also other rulers, like the perspective ruler, and you set the perspective and so on. So I think it's a very valid extension. Subtle. Okay, I'll go back. Oh no, I have ants in my leg. And I'm just sitting here since less than 10 minutes. Oh no, it's already 20 minutes. Time flies. I've lost it. Okay, here. Oh, okay, that's why you use laziness in me. See, it's, yes, it's because it's comfortable and you can do a lot of stuff with it. Okay, remove this. Incredible that PS creators never added by default, sometimes build something geometrical, it's terrible. Remove this in times part. You have to build scripts to do that stuff. When some or the ruler perspective thing, like Clip Studio Paint has it, and even Paint Tools I now, but Photoshop not yet. Even though almost every artist that does digital painting use it, but they never bothered. Maybe they will in the future. It would be super nice. Okay, so the tail is definitely bigger than the body, but I wanted to have this covered by this sexy leg here. So, shouldn't be too much of a problem. I have to have the same color over here. And this must match as well. So I wanted to refine the shape of this because I just did a very basic shape. I agree, it's weird. So, focus. Okay, so I wanted to add some shadows to this. I also wanted to refine it. Okay, I'll do a quick sketch on this. Quick sketch, but I have to change brush. Okay, can use this, can I? Too big, need something else, this, okay, just have it slightly smaller. Wanted to resketch this because I'm not entirely convinced about it. Just wanted to get an idea of what I'm doing. This is a foot, it's like a human foot. What about this? Because they have different shapes. Let's take inspiration from dogs. I'll go get some dogs images to get as reference. Dogs. Oh, yes. Need to find dog scene from. Maybe not a dog, maybe some kind of reptile. Varano. Let's check. Yeah. And this is the most resemblant creature to a dragon, probably. So I want to take inspiration from them to do the legs, but not too much, because this. I mean, we're still in time to design this, so. Are they cuddling? Are they killing each other? Oh, okay, so this. It's similar, but the opposite. It looks like it's a paper doll. No, a doll. Yeah, one of the old doll. Stick here, which is an option. And then it has this. Pose like this. The skin is muscular, but I don't like it very much. But the pose are nice. I just left the shift pushed and rotate the plan with air to have some geometrical lines. Oh, I see. Rotate the plan. Let me try that. Shift and there. Oh, and then I want to reset the view. Okay, cool. They look dangerous creatures. And this here does not bend like it bends. Oh no, yes. So shouldn't be like a dog bow then, but it should be more straight. So if this is going to be, should be more straight here too, then it has this. And if we do the same on the back one, need the reference. What long powers it has. It looks almost like a lizard. Bends in weird ways. Bends like this. Bah. I'm still unsure about the inspiration we are getting for the dragon specifically in anatomical sense. Oh, this looks like a normal leg though. So it's just that it's standing like this. Weird. Well, when in doubt, think of human anatomy with different proportions. You're right. You're always right, Paquichetus. So I want to give it the food, but I don't want to make it too obvious, so I'll redo it again. It's the same number and kind of pants. Maybe I'll just make it slightly up, like this. So this is its foot. This could work. Check. Mostly user, but never use it to do the precise lines. So. I shouldn't start adding details. Let's make something. Ooh, maybe elephants. Let's look at elephant. Oh, is this a real? Yes. Okay, I have to take out the opacity because I want to delete this part. I wonder if I got the shape right. Refrain from adding. I'll try to keep it as simple as possible. After all, doesn't even have proper jaws, so hope you'll forgive me for this. So I'll try to get the tail to have this size. Okay. So it's easier to match it with the rest. Now I'll leave that. I'll lower the opacity of this and I'll redo the shape to match this. Too many points. Okay. So as I explained last time, I'm using the lasso because I'm lazy to get the shape done first quickly. This is what I was thinking. Oh god, have a look. No, I can't have a look. Try to get this quickly down. I'll redo it, I know it. I'm curious about the link. Did it open? Okay. Oh! Cool, thank you. What you got? Got it in the meanwhile? Yeah, it's kind of similar. Can take for sure inspiration. mine is less large. And the front one, I want to check. I trust the expert about animals. And this one, yeah, they're somewhat similar. I got this part up differently. It's this, oh, this is the elbow, right? Try to, oh, which I lost when I redid this. The Komodo dragon has its legs spread apart. Your dragon's anatomy is more like a dog, actually. I know. Oops. It's already useful for bracing bones. Yes. Can I just see the image? Oh, super small. So copy this, paste it. Now use it as a reference. Try to redo it. Otherwise, I never learn. So you would have done it lower. I still would like to cover the butt in a single piece. So I'll leave this a bit round. Then, oh, this part was similar. Then you would have done it lower. And so more like the dog. Yes, it's not the same. Does it need to be larger here? Cover the butt. Nah, they're animals. Now, this upper part, this is the one that was giving me doubt. So this is the hand, the human hand. Yeah, it's very dog-like. Thank you. Then we add dangerous things here. And, oh, here I'd like to add. No, let's not add anything. No. This will be to be like this. Cool. We have a good, very good starting point. I had to do that. Couldn't help myself. Get this into sketches. And I was thinking about the dragon fruit that we have here. Wow, so many sketches. Need to deactivate some. Okay. Well, this was a new one, and I wanted to get these kind of frills as well. So I wonder if it should have this sort of frills here. It would be super nice. Okay, I wanted to see a picture of a dragon fruit and they turned out to be all open, making things difficult. Wow, the texture of this fruit is amazing. It's so beautiful. I heard it doesn't have this exceptional taste, but I've never tried it myself. It's a red fruit in my zones. I mean, I guess I could find it in some market, but I've never tasted it. Yeah, I'll have to redo it. I was just getting an idea. So maybe it's too big, the texture, if we compare it to the rest of the animal. I want to have something, because here the tip is very green, very, so it could be this, like this. And then I also wanted to make sure it had, so, oh yes, this could cover the upper body here, maybe this as well, and then maybe have one here, it reminds me of the Chinese dragon, and this year we're in the year of the dog. And the dog somehow has the same similar features except the face. So, find it moderately interesting. Here it will have this. Here not. And here it's still missing. And then it has the wings. Well, for this part, I don't really know how to do it. But the inner part is going to be in this color probably. Speaking of dogs, we need to go see Isle of the Dogs when it comes out. Saw an exhibition in London with original sets. What is it? Is it a film about dogs? It's turning out a very fancy dragon. Yeah, I have to watch who gave me the idea. I guess Ravi D for the dragon fruit, because it was an amazing idea. A Wes Anderson film, stop motion. Isn't he the same one that did Budapest Hotel? Or am I getting confused? I often mistake the names. So it would be unfortunate, but ah, he is. Ah. I love that film and the face that he had, and the fact that everything is so symmetrical in his films. Okay, focus. Yeah, I'm sure that that film is worth watching, at least for the aesthetics. Excuse my typing, keyboard is a weird position. Oh, I didn't even notice. Okay. I'm lowering the opacity on this and redo this. And I'll lower the opacity on this as well. I hope you caught up on Wes Anderson at this point. Fabiano, you didn't see any of Wes Anderson film? Okay. And now it's time. Let's try to do this right. Of course I didn't yet. I can only say that I really enjoyed the films by Wes Anderson. So if you haven't, you should watch them. They have this, I love how they thinking those films and the atmosphere. So love trash movies, but that's another story. We'll take you to Isle of Dogs anyway. You know, if you take it out of context, it's like I imagine an aisle full of dogs. And that's an aisle I would love to live in. As long as the dogs are peaceful. Why? Besides, in Japan, they do have those places like the Isle of Cats. So, in the first 5 seconds before I realized you were talking about a film, I was kind of hoping it was an aisle full of dogs. Much pleasure likes stop motion a lot. The last stop motion film that I saw was Kubo and the Magic Strings, or Kubo and the Two Strings, because it has a different name in Italian. And it was amazing. I really love the character design. And it's true, I know that they did some previsualization of the film in Maya and then printed or modeled the faces one by one. But it still had that sort of magic in it. The magic of something done by hand, so. If you remember Coraline, there was a behind the scene in Coraline where the most impressive thing was that there was a person that would knit all the clothes for the various tiny characters in the film, or arrange their hairstyles. It's amazing. Okay, so now I have a ton. Oh, this is a useful one, so I'll leave it out. Useful sketch, maybe I'll move it to sketches. And what's this? This is another useful sketch. I have to change window here. Okay. Move it to sketches and deactivate it. What's this old sketch? I don't really need this. What's this old sketch? More bear like. Here, another old sketch, delete. Ah, now it's clean. This is the old version, way better, yes. Oh, thank you for suggesting the right way of doing this. Then, you should also see Pirates by Aardman, speaking of stop motion. It's a lot less known, but it's pretty good. Pirates by Aardman. I guess it talks about pirates, hasn't it? I'll have to search it. Might as well delete this too. Now it's the turn. Oh, where's my leg? Okay, here. I have to do this. Muscles. I didn't double click. Okay. Although Although there's a lot of 3D, but still a great movie. Nobody said they weren't allowed to cheat. If it helps, and we do have the technologies, then why not? Alright. Yay, finished. Should be similar. Have doubts about the front one. I probably didn't do it well enough. Actually, I'm all for using the best technique for a specific result. I agree. Cheat? Maybe to an outsider it could be cheating. I call it cheating, but it's a good way of cheating, of course. If you can do something that would require a lot of more time and it makes it easier, it's kind of like cheating, but it's not like you're really cheating. I guess it's as good as it can be. I want to look. What did I act? Ah, it's swatches. If I deactivate this, this is the other sketch. Oh, here it was. So I guess it's right. Very good. I wonder if I should have made it more round, more fat. Fattier dragons are cool. Maybe. We'll see. In the meanwhile, let's start doing these limbs. So, no wasting time. The right color again. There, and the leg front. There. How was the old one? Different. I'll take these two and move them up and make them perfect. Electrical skateboard. I was reading the names. That's a fine name. Now I have to get the coloring right for this. Reduce the hardness, reduce the opacity. And I can do this. I just saw that scallion could be translated with chip. And dragon made of chips. When I think of chips, I think of fries. I don't know about you, but of course chips are also tiny things. It's not just the first comes to my mind. Funny. Hearing light switches. Maybe someone is in the house. Okay. Oh, didn't I click four? Okay. Saving. And let's get in some basic light here. And I need to erase some parts. Make this better later. So basically, this dragon has a red base. Basically, red base. Sounds stupid. And has its butt uncovered. I'm sorry, bad logic. It's probably more methodical to start adding the shadows and the basic color at first, so that you do all the pieces the same style. Probably won't need this, nor this really. For sure not this. I like this for the lower part. Try to redo it. It's not an easy choice. So first I get the basic lights here. I have them match. Here it has wings, so I'm adding some lights in advance, some shadows in advance. Then I want it to kind of match the tail here. More or less need a big looks like a bird, since it doesn't have... What about if I just give him legs? Ah, the legs in the back are too far away to make it look like a bird. But what if the leg, instead of being placed there, oops, was placed here? Then it would be a bird creature with a strange body, but still a more bird-like creature. And then let's see, the arm front, instead of being there, if it was no, it would have to necessarily be wings instead of this. It was fun. Okay. Looks like a parrot. Saving. So, I said I wanted to add the dragon fruit style things. Which are these? Which are so cool. And have this here. I'll need to have them on a separate layer. This would make the number of layers increase a lot, possibly. Okay. This is the head, so I'll make a new group and I'll start sketching this. Hardness. Oh no, hardness. I need a different pencil here, like this one. Ah, yes. More like what I had in mind. Then here. Okay. Make this tiny. Oh, not strong enough. Did you see the shape of the water in the end? Saw it and I liked it. Oh, you did. Glad you liked it too. That's a cool shape. Let's see if I can replicate that shape. This. No, of course. Nice. this is not the best technique for the but I still wanted to have some big scales to cover it easy in an easy way for the other ones. I like them, but I also don't like them because I have to draw them. fabulous, but are they right? Yes. Okay, then another one here. I still need another one over there. A big random color. Oh. Needs to be in the front so I see everything well. So maybe I'll just get another one here behind and I'll refrain myself from adding more. One is needed. Ugly. Enough. And saving. Yeah, the rest I can just paint it over on the body. So saving, and I'll have to make groups for each of these. So group, And I'll have to select the red. And fill it with red. And then make a layer. And add the green, like for the other ones. Deactivate the sketch for now. So the green is very light here in the beginning, and then it becomes dark at the end. Have transparency, and then it's just painted everything red. It's transparent, yes. It's not painting. I'm doing it on the wrong layer. Create a clipping mask on the right thing instead of that. What's this? I created it by mistake. Okay, so now the green is visible. Just add some more, and then I'll remove some from the center to make it similar to this one. Copy. And then on the tip, it needs to be slightly darker. Didn't want to do it this way. This is basically the color. And then with shadow. Shadow color. Great. Okay, brush settings are perfect. And I create the scales. Easy, okay. Then I just use this to, and then I move on to the next thing. This. So I create a new group. I'll create a new clipping mask, and I'll fill this with my red. There. Then on this color, on this layer, I use the green color with transparency. Okay, good enough. Here I'll do the tip a bit darker, and then I'll add the shadows on the other layer as I did for the other one. Definitely I want some shadows here. Here as well, to make it scale like. Then give some more decisive strokes. Yes. And then I'll give some light here. Not too much. Okay. Maybe not a light. Okay, next one, group. So I guess none of you ever tried this famous dragon fruit. I know there's also ice cream flavor. Dragon fruit flavor? You haven't? Didn't know it existed. It's probably an American fruit, because I only ever saw it when I went to America once. But the American people have probably just woken up now, so they can't tell us what they know about dragon fruit, unfortunately. Unless there's American people among you. I discovered about dragon fruit because of a game I was playing, Don't Starve. You could, it was one of the things you could get from harvesting crops. And it had this weird shape, and I thought it was an invention of the game. For actually discovering that it exists. Did I get this right? More or less. And then some eraser. Super strong eraser. Missing odd here. I was trying to hide. Right color, yes. And then shadow. So here. Sort of looks like a desert plant. I wonder where it grows. I meant the dragon looks like a desert plant right now. But I still wonder where the dragon fruit grows. More scales. Let's do more group and here. Okay. dusty. Shadow time. I'm not entirely convinced by how I did the shadow here. It's getting worse. Mission abort. It's not as bad as I first thought it would end up, which makes me happy. It's pretty, but I kind of lost the purple shade of the dragon fruit. Maybe it's too much red. I should add some purple somewhere. Oh, I forgot the white here. I'll add it later. Oh, and this needs a group on its own. So F4, then new layer, then green. So this is in front, but it should be in. Green, here. Transparency. I've got one of them. It's here. It escaped its fate. I have to move this out of the way. Oh no! There. Oh, there's another one that I didn't notice. It's starting to look pretty. Let's see it from afar. It's almost a legit dragon. Still misses its wings. work. Okay, zoom in. And here, shadow time. I'm doing shadows on the wrong layer. No, oh, I can't see anything. Okay. Not okay. Okay. And then erase it on the tip. Perfect. Next, I already did that. This too. This as well. This. Okay, I didn't do this. So I'll do it now. Slightly bigger. Good enough. Oh, I placed one folder inside the other. Okay. Shadow. The last one here. Oh, neat. That's a griffin. It looks like a griffin, you see? You think? Maybe it's a griffin. What can I say? What would make it more dragon-like? It's a horse. Thanks, Mariana. Evil. More evil. How can we make it more evil? I could make him dark eyes instead and not so colored. I swear I am able to make dangerous looking things, but sorting this phase of my life where everything I draw ends up being cute, and I apologize deeply for that. This case like that done. I think the wings will make it look a lot more dragonish and skills like that. Down detail will help. Yeah, I agree, it's not finished yet. I'm a cuddly dragon. Don't listen to me though, it's your vision. If I didn't listen to you, we would have ended up with a dragon with just the front wings. They would have been the hands instead. is making my spare time a project doing all sorts of Dragon Anatomy. It would be cool. I'm in a cuddly dragon mood, yes. You know, in what mood am I? I really want to finish the book that you suggested. I'm at chapter 30 of the second book of The Way of Kings. But the second book, which I forgot the name, because I'm just reading and I'm not even paying attention to the name of the second book. And it's so amazing. Oh, maybe it's the front legs that make me think griffin. Yeah, they're actually very inspired by dogs, and I got a little help from Pachycetus to figure them out. So that they are correct. Okay, time to finish the body. Got to make this right. The shadow was fine. Don't need this anymore. Oh, a message. I mean, the second Stormlight Archive book, Words of Radiance by Brandon Sanderson, which is awesome. I agree, it's awesome. I want to start drawing that actually. I noticed that there are not many drawings about it, and I felt like, oh, I have to draw Syl because she's so cute, and I have to draw the. I'm not mentioning anything because it would be a spoiler, so I won't talk about it. But I'd like to start sketching it. And I like it. Thank you for the suggestion. Okay. Time to add more scales here. Try to do it as we did for the other ones. And then on the inner part. Some cool art at brandonsanderson.com. Careful with spoilers, though sometimes it's disappointing if the art doesn't match what's in my head. I agree. I'll look it later since it looks like the official link of the author. It would be easy to remember. For example, I don't like the art of the books of the covers. It's like they already don't look like what I had in my head. I'm going to open that second link because I don't know what it is. Oh. Oh, so that's how the safe hand is covered. Cool. It do actually look nice. It's true when they say that it looks elegant. Can't discuss the book, but I would like a lot to do it. Now, this part, I want it to be white, like the inside of this root, or gray. Gray is fine as well. Arm front, arm back. save. And I'll add the tiny points on this. Tiny points. I want them in the same style of the horns. And then if I don't like them, I'll change them. Which is a thing that happens often. Me not liking this stuff. Okay. Was it chalk? It was smaller chalk. It looks like a dalmata, but in reverse. No, someone cut this dragon skin. Yeah, actually. Because this is the inside, so. You're right. Or maybe it's like when you see the bear skin and this is the fur. Fur. Dun, dun. So it looks like this. Oh, it's not. I redo them. There's not a pattern. They are very scattered. Peel dragon. Okay, now I deactivate. Legs again. It's kind of like bois or pois or whatever you call them. It's bois in theory, but more scattered. Weird. Okay. Maybe I should add tiny leaf here to cover this part, or at least a green border. Yeah, poor baby. Maybe I could also do it here and for the inside of the legs. I'm always thinking about dogs in this. This is it. Not a dragon, it's a dog in disguise. Okay. We'll delete this layer since it's not used. Okay. Need to drag this up so it will be able to cover the rest. And I have to go back to my old brush setting here. Let's try with just a line. No! I just deleted it. Every line I did before this. Gotta be careful. Delete the leg. Need to add some spacing, I'm afraid. What is wrong with this? Shape dynamics. Okay.
So now it can be smaller. Way better. Then I delete this part, which is excessive. And here as well. Need to add a tiny bit more green here. Then here there's a light that is not from this world. I'll correct the light later. First finish this. I got on the wrong layer. Okay. Now it looks like a bug instead. It's actually logical if the dragon looks like a bug, because bugs are the only creatures that have six limbs. Bugs and crustaceans. Just doing some scales here in case the lower part is seen. Then I need to see this one better. Oh, I made scales that make sense. Incredible. Let's check. Fair enough. Yeah, this part doesn't need scales at all. I was adding too many scales. I wonder if I should leave them or just get rid of them. Oh baby. Yeah, I'll delete. Great. part was covered anyway, so. Great. Now, lodge the missing shadow since I finished doing the pattern on the body. Very big shadow. Or the lower leaves. Some of the shadow from this part, maybe. Then add it again. Then delete it from here. Just to add it again above. To make it more scale-like. This double scale isn't convincing me. It's like I had too many scales and I probably just need one. Maybe I should just cover this part with another one of these leaves. Let's see. What leaf is that? Duplicate it and then transform it. Distort it? No, I can't. Oh, I have to transform it again now to make it longer. And it's too similar to the other one, so I'll have to redraw it. Unfortunately. Maybe I can just rotate this one. About perspective deformation. Rotation. Oh, they don't look so similar anymore. Okay. It looks like he's wearing a coat besides being peeled. Interesting. Now, I wonder if I should redo the things that it has on the neck, because they're in a slightly different style to match everything else. In the meanwhile, I'll finish doing the arms and legs. So, delete that. And this still needed these spikes. Feral. Where they are. All this. And similar to the sketch. Cool. Where are these spikes? Spikes. All these other swatches. Oh, an empty layer. Let's check if it's empty. Oh, yeah. No pixel selected. I can reuse it for something. The legs, where are they? Ah, here. Okay, perfect. Now here it is. Spike style. They're like tiny drops, but in reverse. Not much to say about them. Nail polish. And here. Pinky finger. I don't know the name of the fingers in English. Just remember thumb, pinky, index maybe. And then there's this and this that I don't know the name of. If they have one. Index, middle, ring, because you put the ring on it. Ah, cool. And pinky, thumb, index, middle, ring, and pinky. I'll teach you some Italian. Thumb is pollice, index is indice, middle is medio, which means the same thing in Italian. Then the ring finger is anulare. And pinky is mignolo. So they're different. Mignolo. Is it called pinky because know of pinky swears that you do like this when you promise something. I'm an Italian teacher. Yes, you can learn about doing things in video games, and I can also teach you some Italian words. Also because I use them when I don't mean to. Sometimes. I'll teach you something that every English native gets wrong. When you say thank you, you say grazie, and no grazie. It's grazie. When I go to concerts, those rare times, I always hear the artists saying
grazie instead of grazie. I figure it's because of how it's written and how you read stuff in English. So you're excused. Okay, so it is front. It's almost time for nail polish here. This one front, and this goes behind. Ooh. I don't like it. I need to make it longer to fit every, or I can drag it back. I can drag everything back. Now it's like both, and I move them slightly to the back. Let's check. I used an eraser that wasn't strong enough. Yeah, I tried. I need to change the shape here. Need to get some shadows in place. So I got the trace, and now I'm going to transform this into proper balls. Has better nails than me, just saying. Wish I had this. But then I wouldn't be able to hold the, or to type too long. I wonder how the girls with very long nails manage to do anything in their lives. Must be hard. Nails are not touch. And they also break fast. Shadow in place. Shadow. Mm-hmm.
Aren't they the actual names of the fingers? Oh, that's a good question. Probably yes, because the middle finger means medio. Yes, it means medio. Medio means middle also in common language, not just for the fingers. And but I'm curious about the pinky one. Yeah, ring is pure genius. It also states that basically they either they have the tradition of marrying by placing a ring on it since very ancient times, or they started naming the fingers after the ring tradition got in place. Or maybe there was another name that replaced that name. For sure it wasn't adopted from Latin. Or maybe it was. And our Italian version is just vulgar. Oh, I'm adding too much shadow. Talking. Well, now I'm thinking about anulare. It comes from an anello. It's true! I didn't think about it either. Whoa. That's cool. Then maybe it is a derivative of Latin, but translated in the native's language. It's actually very cool. Okay, it looks flat here. So let's correct this. I got the front arm done. Ah, my leg. It's sleeping. Do you say that it's sleeping when... Or that you have marching ants in it? I should have been sitting properly. Ouch. Ah, nails. Almost forgot about the nails. So they make the nails like the white part. So stupid, I want to try it. So first shadows. I should walk a little bit. Ouchie. Every time I move the leg a little bit, it hurts. Aww, what have I done? Capacity is set to perfect. Cordelia Demon, Cordelia Demon. Ah, this is so trash. It's so bad. I'm almost tempted to keep this. I'm not sure. It's the worst nail polish I've ever seen. Probably something that I'd be able to do at home alone and never move. I don't know. Maybe I'll leave them black instead of white or some other color. More points. Now lots of points here as well. Just because. Watch out for too many details. Ah, too. Thank you. Yeah, it's actually useless to place that nail polish. But the arm didn't turn out. Like, I'm almost satisfied with the arm. Yeah, I removed the nail polish, but it was fun for a brief while. Gotta add some details to the back. Stupid nail polish. I'll change it later. Same. Make it in a straight line. No, it's too big. Shiny nail polish. It's clearly shining. And now the other one too. Saving. Got up this shadow here. Lowering the opacity because this is ridiculously strong. shorty fingers. Adding a shadow because there's the leaf up here. And now that I got some shadows in place, I should add another shadow for this leaf as well. Gotta refine these shadows first. By the way, I was wondering, I know that some of you are following since the first Twitch stream, and by the way, thank you. Were you able to test what we did in the other streams on your own rigs? I saw something on Twitter, I know that some people did. I really appreciate when people tag me in the things they do. If they followed something that we did in the stream. So I know they actually followed the stream. Erased a good part. Okay, I'll try to stop here to not give too many details. But if here it's so dark, I need to get some more darkness on this lower. No, maybe let's not paint it once. I have a problem. I'm adding again too many. Nobody would pay attention to that anyway. Revert. Keep it simple, keep it simple. Easier said than done. Lower capacity. Generic shade is coming in to help. Yes. Almost done. Too shaded here, probably. I guess I have to stop because I keep adding shadows on shadows. I guess this one is darker than this. And it's the basic shadow that makes it darker. So I have to delete some of the shadows. Oh, I destroyed some good details. Okay, what's this one? Still on the right layer. Lower the opacity. When it's break time, now it's break time, you're right, I got caught up. Yeah, it's yogurt time, right? What flavor this time? So finish the water. I saved. You'll tell me later. Okay, break. Thanks for reminding. Vanilla. Okay. There, put your animation. Nate, look at this!
come back. Ta-da. Okay. Now I remember that I wanted to add a shadow here under the leaf. Which was... And that's the leg. Here I have the arm. Create a separate one. And I make the shadow under the leaf. Check by removing figure that I'll make a mess like this. Make it darker. Too dark. Exactly. Well, this looks nice. And now this one too. So leg, this. Okay. This is wrong. Let's check. Didn't need to add that one. Yes. Okay, so I'm saving. And maybe I can also add a shadow here on the body. Fine. You can also leave this without any texture, like this part of the trick. Save. And... Okay, so now I can do the tail. Or I realized I never finished the jaw. Want to get the face right. Since today is a better day than last time, it needs to be finished. I'll delete this nefastous layer. I still like this. I'd leave it. Oh, here it is. I need to add some shadow inside here. Oh. So strong. It works. Perfect. Nah, strong, strong. Okay. Then here. And this part, it became a single piece. Detached, but I wanted it to mix nicely instead. So I'll have to remove this part here. Let's detail a bit the eye. Simply deleted this part to make it look like a fold in the skin. I'll do the same here. It looks already more like an eye. But I want to in it here. And then add some more shadows here. It's a happy dragon now. Or a sad dragon. Depends on your part of you. Could also add folds in here. But I would be adding too many details, I'm sure. Let's refrain from doing his mission abort. Go back. It did look nice. Yes, he is, because I moved the pupil to get a... But I can move it. I moved the pupil to make an image, see? And now it's looking to another side. It's supposed to look that way. I moved it for the sake of the promotional image. Okay, then. Oh no, but I figured I did it. I moved the eye back in place again. Wait a minute, I'll take it out. I never finished doing this eye, it's not even symmetrical. Do it very quick. So, okay, this was the second shadow, and this is the first shadow that I got a bit wrong. Can't do this. What's missing? The border. The border that every eye has. No, not that. Bad Erica, don't add too many details. I think you could slightly soften the front tooth. It's a bit sharp, maybe. Front tooth? Oh, this one. Yeah. I could. I'll get to that as well. Didn't look right. You could maybe follow the thickness to start another line towards inside. Ah, you mean, and make it double. Yeah, I had the plan to do it. Yes. I want to finish the eye first. Okay, I think I got it. Oh, I hate it when I think I can't. But I think I grabbed the whole thing and really I didn't. Better. And I also want a tiny sparkle of joy in his eyes, his or her, in its eyes. Bit lower. Maybe a bit transparent. Transparent is a bad idea. Let's try by a little bit transparent, but giving a stroke here in the middle. I could add a ton of details to this. Do it as a circle instead. Let's do it as a circle so I don't get tempted to redo it a thousand times with this neck. I'll just make a circle like this. Right? Perfect. I don't know where to place it. Make a test. So let's say it's here. This should be better. Here, probably. Let's take it back. Call this eye spark. And I'll add a
glow to this normal. Alright, do I see nothing? Weird. Maybe it's because of the spread. Yes. Oh, now it's fine. It looks like a true sparkle, sparkling. Perfect. Saving again. Whatever. Okay, now I can do that. The jaw and the skull. So what did you send? Let's check. Ta-da-da-da. It's loading. Aha. This part could be more like this. Ah, so that's what you meant. It all makes sense now. This is why it's very nice to have artists on the stream. Thank you. Hardness. It loses its, like, it looks like it's less dangerous, but not that it looked dangerous from the start, so. Nah. Okay, so now I have to attack another part. For sure, I'll need to get the horn better. It's starting to look cool. I also wanted to do those wings we were talking about. Oh, I have to replicate this in the back as well, the legs. Okay, I can do it. I can do it. Unfortunately, this part. No! Try to be less destructive by adding masks, so I can reverse this. And I will give him the chance. Okay, so here.
perfect. And or instead I need some more shadow specific to it. Get the horn out and the ears as well. Ear, it's a single ear for that. And this is too hard. Almost the same. I have to understand what to do with that part that should be able to open. Let's check the jaw for a moment. Maybe I gave him too many teeth for the lower part. Think about it. Maybe to add some shadow here or not. Maybe I remove some from here. Some of the green. That was useless move. And the copy of the leaf. Wanted to add the shadow here. And then like this layer. Yes, and then so here I have to set perfect. And it's like this, opacity, cool.
Not much is left. Want to get the ears. Nice. The skull didn't have the right. The ears like this would be fine. And there's the horn. Not really the horn. It'll have to be behind the ear. Because usually horns are in the middle and never. Nah. I might just make the horn less tall, just move it up slightly. I might change the base. Here, for example. And then I have a problem with the ears. Do this. This might work. I need to change those shadows. Okay. I need to do the other horn as well. And I can resume doing the draw. Looks like this one is still darker than this one, but slightly. I could try to wear the opacity using this. Oh, what happened? So it looks like Photoshop froze. But it works. Then Oh, it's a tablet that froze. No, Ben. Why are you doing this to me? Clearly not working. Ah, so it's just a pen. What if I turn it off? I'll try to turn it off. I still see everything. I'll turn it on. Ah, now it works. I made a copy instead. Okay, so now I'll be lowering the opacity here. Looks better. I didn't want to destroy these shadows here. Let's duplicate them. Place them behind. Then maybe slightly move them. So I just noticed that it's better if the nails don't go past the body here. So instead of duplicating, I'll just first refine the nails. So here. How many groups? Okay. Transform it again. And let's do the same for the front. So I'll select them, create a group, and then transform the group. So they were like this, and now they're like this. I guess they're fine. I'd like to give them yellow shadow. Some yellow. Or the yellow green. And instead of that, this. And then green. It looks very cool. Now the bad leg.
perfect.
Okay, so close this, save it, and make a copy finally. Great. Now this leg, and just start the sort of shadow here. So I'll select the shadow color. Exaggerated with this shadow, so do this, then I'll apply the mask. Perfect. Okay, then I wanted to try to give it some gray color, like the body, which had this color, I believe. I was dangerously serious when I said that I wanted to do that. Ah, it's better not to erase. And then I need to chalk there. Need a slightly smaller. Activate the body. I have to delete these two because they go in the way of that one. And now I'll create some smaller, and then one here. Okay. Spirit in the body, and fine. Need more shadow for that. Maybe I'll just raise the opacity of this layer to the maximum. Let's check. Okay. So maybe I could add some more shadow. Check without the front. Okay, then I really just need it around there. I don't need the rest of the gradient that I created, so select, inverse, delete, deselect. Oh my. I did it on the wrong layer, of course. And just go back to before I made the gradient. And paste it. I didn't place in the right position. No, it's in the right position. Okay. Yeah, it's a very long work. I'm sorry. But it's also true that we're almost close to where the good part. Now renaming them correctly, like back, okay, and arm back. Don't worry, it's a good thing we can see every step of the workflow. Okay. Yeah, these are, I guess, realistic times. Don't think I'm particularly slow. Okay, so the front paw has these nails like this. The other paw might just have two of them. Move this here and hide this. And then can close this one here. Brush. I need to erase the middle lines. Erasing the wrong thing again. I'm lost. So, okay, so one is here. And then I'll change the shadow here. Oh, wrong. Soft round, perfect. Hi, Temfree. We are at the good point with the dragon. Oh, I'm using the black again, so that's what was wrong. Belly design, it's from the dragon fruit, came out like this. Thank you. And then I just need to add a bit of shadow. Oh, I pressed it wrong. Okay. So, shadow here. So, I'll deactivate this. And maybe take the shadow up. Okay. Saving. Still need to finish the jaw and the head design. Then the tail needs some more details. And I need to finish the wings. Need to make the wings. Didn't have the design started. Don't even have them yet. Okay. No more detail. Yes. It's my problem that I add too many details. I somehow dodged the risk of adding tiny scales on every part of this. But we're not safe. I'll die if I ever do a full body thing of the dragon. Of the dragon I did. It's long. And okay, so maybe I'll get the tail here done with some detail. Okay, let's have a look. It's a good thing to take a small break. Wow, looks very cool. Mac Toxic Dragon. And so you actually did the full thing. And look at all those muscles. Those are hands. Lovely. All those muscles, it's amazing. I can see that this is a foot, not a foot, this is a... Very cool. Oh, you didn't make it? The other painted myself. Nice, you have the skills anyway. All these muscles. Oh, it's a prank. Got me enthusiastic about some... Those hands. Like, it's obvious this is a person, you know? Wow. Then we go back to these and it's, oh, it's not the same thing. It's good I didn't add the pink in it. Would have made it. Ah, and the design is by an artist on DeviantArt. Oh, I see. Is it from a video game or is it just something random that you found? I like your design, it's really cute. And the fruit idea is cool. Yeah. Who had the fruit idea? I have to go and search it. Oh, so good anyway. The animated, it will go even better. I'm sure. Okay. Not much is left. I could attempt to do detail because it's something relaxing. Doesn't require much thinking. Yes, could do that. So I'll start with that technique of taking the green. No, just random design. He did as adaptable jar design. My friend bought it for me. The beans. The bean bought it for me, the bean, because I loved it. Huh. Oops. I think she only did the, she or he, I don't know. They only did the head of the monster. I've tried this. Okay. I didn't so far. I only had a little win, a little whip of a head on him. The one you posted in Discord, right? Do you find actually useful to see me doing the assets, or would you prefer to just see the rigging? Because I was wondering if I should finish this so that next time we can animate it, or finish the wings on a stream. I prefer watching some spine workflows so that if there's a curious piece we should take a look at. Already finished piece. Okay, take note. Someone could want some creation tricks. True. Besides, I still need the time to prepare them, so I might as well just stream the process. What is on this layer? Nothing. Okay, this explains a lot. I want to add some shadow. Ah, it's called touch. Why is it in image mode? Okay. As always, CMYK, and I got worried that I somehow messed up changing the format, which of course needs to be RGB because you're not printing this. Mm-hmm. will we do after the dragon? I still have that painting to do ready. I have to refine this. Did it a bit. What can do better than that? Getting tired. Ooh. Yes. Maybe I'll finish it later. For now, I'll save. Maybe I'll move to making the wings. What am I moving around? I don't know. Yeah, just to change a little bit. Let's do the wings. Oh, these are majestic wings. Yes. This is a useless drawing now. Hello, RevVD. Afternoon all, late to the party. Yeah, I'd rather see more rigging animation, but you've got to make the art sometime. At least we get to see what it happen rather than a stream for a week. Yes, thank you for your understanding. Besides, I let you choose the details of this, which I found fun. Personally enjoyed letting you pick some the number of limbs or the style of this. So thank you. Then wings. Sketching first, new layer and wings. So if the wings are like these, gotta be 5 of them. I only just noticed now that I have the fruit behind me. Now I'm completely behind the fruit. Cool. Back to the topic. Wings. They were here. Yes. So there needs to be 5 of them, right? If they were like the bat. But maybe it's not like the bat, so let's have a look at the old sketches here that we had. I should have somewhere the net. So many sketches. Ah, there. So many possibilities. I guess OBS disconnected for a very brief time. So the wing would be like this. And then we need to do the wing also on the opposite side. Yep. They tried to sell us Tomb Raider movie and energy drink. I'm sorry. Cause I got disconnected. So I'll need to draw four pair of wings because it's this, then the one that it's low, then the one in the back, which I probably can obtain from this in a mirrored version. Maybe it's not so many. Okay, let's try this. Move the sketch to beside here so that it's not in the way. And my sketch on the way. To me, they always show the latest gaming PC. When I look at it, it's both. There's a period when doesn't matter what I open, it's always the Tomb Raider movie. And there's other days in which it's just the computer. Okay, I might want to do this with pasts because it's easier. So first this, I'll make this a shape, and then I'll adjust the shape. Keep getting a deselection. I need to add another point. here. Deactivate these gadgets for now. Then this. Perfect. And now it's here. Group this. Some algorithm has checked our bank accounts. I think yours won. And how would they? How many times did I wrote I merge instead of merge? Must have copied and pasted it. Wing. Name I merge. I did it too many times. That could be, but the algorithm doesn't remember that the next year I'm gonna pay lots of taxes. Then it will show me something regarding charity on GS. Did you hear the child screaming just now? Probably not. I hope you didn't.
Still screaming. Turned out nicely. I wonder if I need an inner and outer part. I should search for some references. This is cool. Let's search for a reference. By the way, in 10 minutes I'll close the stream because I have to go. And pets are so cute. Look at this face. Giant ears. I wanted to check if the inside and the outside are. Look at this bed. Not exactly the kind of bed I was expecting. But it looks like the inside and the outside. Ah, that's a drawing. They match. I should just need to make this part lighter, really, and adhere the thumb. Double bed. It. And instead I made a copy and I used the green, which was working so nicely, and I'll bump up the something. flying fox fruit bat.
Oh, thanks.
Let's have a look.
Ah, oh, they're cute. They look like tiny dogs. Flying fox fruit bat. Which reminds me of that story of the flying bat. The flying dog. They cute. Are they very big? Because I might have seen one flying. Like the size of a small cat.
Mm-hmm.
Still, a small cat that flies, it's bigger than most birds, isn't it? Well, at least now it has the shape of a dragon. So I'll end today's stream here, and not much is left. Maybe I'll try to go a bit further on my own. Thank you for the precious advice that you've given me during the stream and your opinion and sharing your thoughts. I've appreciated them all. And see you next week. And I'm sure that by Thursday we'll be able to animate this. Maybe already Tuesday. See you! Take care as well.